Big news out of Hong Kong, where thousands of angry protesters have stormed the city's parliament, smashing through windows and clashing with police. CNN international correspondent Andrew Stevens joins us now from Hong Kong. Andrew, clearly a very, very volatile situation. Just if you could, describe the scene for us, what you've witnessed.
Well, here we are, George. It's just gone 5 o'clock in the morning here in Hong Kong, and it is now all calm. But in the last few hours, there have been scenes in Hong Kong that have never been seen before. I'm standing outside the Legislative Council building. This is, in effect, Hong Kong's parliament. And you can see these smashed glass. This is heavy plate glass smashed by protesters who took hours to smash through this with makeshift battering rams, with hammers, with any sort of material they could get on, until they forced their way through here, leave it up that metal roller door, and actually got into the parliament proper. And there were hundreds poured in here. They rampaged through this building. They got into the actual the area where the laws are debated. They defaced the chamber. They tore down pictures, and they spread graffiti across the walls. And they were in there for several hours while the police took no action. Eventually, the police did come into this square just out the front where we're standing at the moment. This was filled with thousands of protesters. The police came in just after midnight using tear gas, swept the protesters out in what was actually quite a peaceful manoeuvre, and then got rid of the final protesters who remained in this building. So about 3 hours or so, order was restored. But these are unprecedented scenes. These scenes in Hong Kong. Hong Kong doesn't do this sort of thing, Georgie, but to see this will be a shocking reminder to many Hong Kongers of the anger and the frustration of these protesters.
And as you say, we've seen weeks of protests. For the large part, they've been fairly peaceful. What sparked this particular incident of such violence?
Well, July the 1st is a protest day, and it has been since Hong Kong was handed back to China in 1997. Officially, this is supposed to be a day, or July the 1st is supposed to be a day of commemoration. It has turned into a day of protest where Hong Kongers air their grievances about all sorts of issues, but increasing over the recent years, it's been about politics. And because the Hong Kong government launched this ill-advised extradition treaty bill, which would allow China to extradite criminals from Hong Kong back to China to face Chinese justice, broadly, wildly unpopular in Hong Kong. The government tried to ram that legislation through, which brought the protesters out initially. On June the 12th, there was further violence, or there's more violence down at this LegCo building, when protesters once again tried to storm it in, but they were beaten back by police using rubber bullets, pepper spray, tear gas. Everything calmed down until the protest took off yesterday, and this group of younger protesters came back down to this building where they have been surrounding it for days now, on and off, to try once again to create that maximum disturbance, that chaos, if you like. They this time succeeded in getting in, and it's all about venting their frustrations. They say the government does not listen to them. There have been peaceful protests of 1 million, 2 million people in recent weeks. The government has not acted on those protests who have been calling for this extradition bill to be scrapped. The government says we will shelve it, but we won't scrap it. And the protesters say, not good enough, we want this thing scrapped. It really is, Georgie, it just underlines the level of despair in many ways that young Hong Kongers have in their future. They say they have no voice in who will rule them in the future, and economically they face pretty tough conditions as well.
Indeed. We greatly appreciate the update. Andrew Stevens in Hong Kong, thank you very much.